Hello and welcome to Geospatial Analysis with Python. So in this session, we'll be looking into NDVI generation from the Sentinel data, and the platform that we'll be using is the Jupyter Notebook. So let's jump into our Jupyter Notebook. Hello and welcome. So today we'll be generating NDVI for Delhi NCR region, and for that, let's import two libraries. First of all, I'll import EE, that is the Earth Engine. Nextly, I'll import GEE map. That's it. I have successfully imported both of them. So if we get an error, so I'll just comment the importing function. You can just write pip install EE, and another library you can just pip install GEE map. So you can install both the libraries using these functions, and you can import both of them using these functions. So let's move ahead and create a variable called map. Now in this variable, I'll pass it on geemap.map function, and I'll just write map in order to create it. So let's see what happens. So as you can see, a map has been generated over here. So this map is similar to your Google map. You can drag it, you can zoom it. So I'll just zoom to my target location. So we'll be creating NDVI for Delhi NCR region. So let's move ahead and just set our map center so that we do not need to zoom again and again. So let's create set center function. So I'll just write map dot set center, and I'll pass the latitude and longitude to it. So these are the latitude and longitude for Delhi NCR region, and I'll pass the zoom level. So the zoom level is 9. You can increase this, you can decrease it. That's it. We are good to go. Let's run it, and map has already shifted itself toward our target location. Now let's create a location point so that we can clip our data. So I'll just create a variable called point, and I'll just pass ee.geometry.point. That's it. I'll pass the same latitude and longitude to it. I'll just put a semicolon. I'll terminate every line with a semicolon, that is the syntax. And if you run it, so you have no error. We have successfully created a location point. Now let's import the data. For that, I'll create a variable called data. And for the data, I'll be using Google Earth Engine datasets. So I'll just open up my browser, and I'll write Earth Engine datasets. So as you can see, these are the datasets. You have to go to this link, developers.google.com, Earth Engine dataset. So I'll go to this link. So we have landed on the Earth Engine data catalog. So here we have Landsat data, Moody's data, Sentinel data, and a huge collection of other datasets. So let's go to the Sentinel data. So here we are on the Sentinel collection page. Let's scroll it down a bit. So as you can see, we have Sentinel 1, SAR data, Sentinel 2, multispectral data. We have Sentinel 3, Sentinel 5. So let's move forward with the Sentinel 2 multispectral instrument data. So I'll just click it, and we have landed on Sentinel 2 dataset. So it has two options. The very first one is the surface reflectance, and the other one is top of atmosphere reflectance. The dataset availability is different for the both the dataset. So let's go with the top of atmosphere reflectance. You can also go for surface reflectance. It hardly matters. So we'll go for top of atmosphere reflectance. And here we are on the Sentinel-2 multispectral dataset. The availability of dataset from 2015 to the current date, and we have dataset provider here. Now we have Earth Engine snippet. I'll just copy it, and I'll jump back to my Jupyter notebook. So now in my data variable, I'll just paste it, and I'll terminate the line using a semicolon, and I'll just play the run button. So as you can see, without any error, we have successfully imported the data into our Jupyter notebook. Now let's clip the data for our location point. So I'll just pass our dot filter bounds function, and I'll pass it on my point location. Now that's it. I'll run it. So now we have successfully imported and clipped our data based on filter bounds function. Let's move forward. Now this data contains a huge amount of information, so let's restrict our search and create a variable called image, and I'll make a function use of ee.image and I'll pass my data into it. Now, I will restrict the data based upon a function filter date, and I'll pass it on the date that I'm using, 2019 01 01, that is the 1st of January 2019, and I'll be using the complete whole year data. So for that I'll be using 12/31, that is the 31st December 2019. So we have successfully clipped the data for this filter date function and for this particular whole year 2019. Moving ahead, this data contains a huge number of data set and a huge number of image collection. So I'll just sort this data based upon a parameter. So what is that parameter? Let's jump back to our data set. Now just scroll it down and you can see a description section over here. So it contains some description about the Sentinel-2 data set. We have a band section. There are several bands. We'll make use of this shortly. Then we have a image property section, and we have a terms of use section. So we'll make use of image properties now. So there are several properties that are mentioned over here. You can find our description over here. So let's make use of cloud coverage assessment. So I'll just copy it and I'll jump back to my Jupyter notebook, and I'll sort my data based upon the cloud coverage assessment. That's it, we have sorted the data. So now from this sorted data, I'll select the very first image using dot first function, and I'll terminate this line of code using a semicolon. I'm good to go. I'll just run the line. So I have successfully clipped the data and restricted my data onto my target location that I have already set over here. Based upon the time series that I have here, we have 2019, 1st of January to 2019, 31st of December. And we have sorted the data based upon the cloud coverage assessment, and we have selected the very first image from that sorted data. So far, so good. Let's move forward. Now, let's create a variable for generating NDVI. So I'll make NDVI variable, and I'll pass my image to it, and I'll pass the function image.expression to it. Now, for that, I'll pass the NDVI function. So this is the NDVI function for that. That's NIR minus red divided by NIR plus red. That is the general function for generating NDVI. Now let's go to our Sentinel-2 dataset. So we'll go to the band section and we'll see what particular band we'll be using. So we are using first band, that is the NIR. We have a 835 nanometer wavelength, 10 meter pixel size, scale is 0.0001, and the name is band 8. So for next band that we are using is the red band, 664.4 nanometer, 10 meter pixel size, and a similar scale, and the name is band 4. So we'll make use of band 8, that is the NIR band, band 4, that is the red band. So let's jump back to the Jupyter notebook and define the red and the NIR bands. So I'll just create another let set, that is the section. Now let's define the variable we have already used, that is NIR, and let's put a colon to it. Now I'll define that image dot select, and for NIR I am using my band 8. That's it. Next I'll move ahead and I'll pass another band, that is the red band. I have already used it, so I'll define it now. We have image dot select, and for that I'll be using band 4. That's it, we are good to go. So what we can do, okay, we can terminate it using a semicolon, and we'll just run it. So this has run without any error. That means we have successfully generated our NDVI image. Now let's add these layers. I'll just pass a function map.addLayer. That's it. And I'll pass my layers. The first layer is the image. The other layer is the NDVI. That's it. That's how you can plot your NDVI image. But before that, let's put it aside and create one more thing for the display. If you run this particular line of code, you'll get an NDVI image, but let's create it more beautiful. So I'll create a display variable over here, and I'll generate a display function. So I'll just create, first of all, I'll create a minimum value and I'll put a colon to it. Then I'll create a maximum value and I'll again put a colon to it. And finally, I'll create a color palette That's it. Okay, we can like this. The syntax is important. Let's put a colon over here. Let's move forward. Take the minimum value as 0 and take the maximum value as 1. That is the general trend. For the palette color, we have some predefined notions for the NDVI that we can use here. So that's it. We have a blue, yellow, green, dark green, and black. So you can use your own palette color, it hardly matters. Let's move forward. But before that, just put commas over here because syntax is important. Now we have to run it, and it has run without any error. So now we have image, we have NDVI, so we do not require this image to be displayed. We have NDVI already. So now I'll pass display over here. That's it. Okay, we are good to go. Let's put a map over here and let's run it. So as you can see, a map has been generated onto Delhi NCR region. So this is a good NDVI image that we have generated. That's it. So we have successfully created an NDVI image for the Delhi NCR region. You can create your own NDVI regions for your own latitude and longitude. That's it. Thank you and see you next time.